Welcome back again in the K Informations. As Chicago pollen season ramps up, doctors give tips on telling COVID-19 from seasonal allergies by Catherine Rosenberg Douglas, Chicago Tribune, April 23, 2020, 5:47 p.m. As captive Chicagoans focus on COVID-19, allergy sufferers have an added layer of worry. Pollen counts for both trees and grass have yet to peak in Illinois, and they're hoping their congestion and cough don't mean something more serious. Figuring out when allergy season starts has gotten harder in recent years because of long cold spells in spring, which have led to an overlap of different kinds of pollen that trigger allergies. At the same time, the Illinois stay-at-home order may be triggering allergies for people stuck in the house with pets. But while allergies and the novel coronavirus show some of the same symptoms, experts say there are ways to tell which people are experiencing. Were it a typical year, tree pollen most likely would peak in April in Illinois, as rates ramp up from March to May, said Dr. Rachna Shah, Loyola Medicine's allergy expert who does pollen counts for the nonprofit Allergy and Asthma Center of Chicago. The second common allergen locally, grass pollen, is then expected to spike, usually lasting from May to the end of June. Ideally, the worst of each would be spread out over several months. But Illinois hasn't had many typical allergy seasons in the past 5 years or so, Shaw said. It is hard to say whether the spring allergy season is abnormal because there isn't a normal recent year to compare it with, but tree pollen levels have yet to hit their high point this year. What we learned in the textbook is not what we have actually been experiencing in Chicago in spring, Shaw said. And the strange weather Chicago has had this April is affecting tree pollen levels and likely prolonged tree season, to the point that it could significantly overlap with the beginning of grass pollen season. The tree season has kind of extended because of these really cold spells that we've had, Shaw said. My prediction is that the first week of May may be really challenging. Those who have known allergies to either tree or grass pollen, they tend to trigger the similar symptoms, Shaw said, can expect itchy eyes and nose, sneezing and a runny nose. Some can develop headaches, nasal congestion and postnasal drip. In some cases, allergies also can lead to or exacerbate asthma, a disease that the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention says can put people at higher risk for more severe COVID-19. Dr. Sharmili Nayan, who's an associate professor at the University of Illinois at Chicago with expertise in allergies and asthma, said there can be some overlap in the symptoms of allergies and the new coronavirus. But the ones that do overlap aren't common for those suffering from the new coronavirus. Getting to the symptom overlaps between allergies and COVID-19, some of the overlapping symptoms can be the runny nose and sometimes the sore throat and the dry cough, she said. Those could be either. Though, it's much more common to have a runny nose with allergies in general, whereas a runny nose in COVID-19 happens less than 10% of the time. The biggest thing with COVID-19 is over 80% of people will have a fever, even with a mild case. And, in patients with allergies, fever doesn't happen, essentially. And usually, we're not seeing the runny nose and sneezing and itchy, watery eyes. With the absence of fever, the probability of it being COVID-19 is low, Nyanhus said. Nyanhus' real concern with COVID-19 and allergies relates more to the effects of the state's stay-at-home order. With people spending more time in their homes than usual, there is a greater chance they will experience symptoms or develop allergies to things such as pet dander, dust mites, or even pests such as mice or cockroaches, she said. And people's attempts to ward off the novel coronavirus can backfire and trigger allergies. Another trigger besides a change in weather is strong odors or chemicals, and people are using strong chemicals to clean more now because of COVID-19, Nyanhus said. Get updates on the coronavirus pandemic and other news as it happens with our breaking email alerts, she said. People should be aware of their environment and take precautions such as wearing a mask when cleaning with harsh chemicals. Those who are prescribed medicine for allergies or those who use over-the-counter remedies may want to ask for a 90-day supply of their medicine or plan to stock up on what they need so they're leaving the house less often. Mold also can trigger asthma and breathing issues, and it's important to check your home, especially with rain in the forecast, Nianhu said. She understands why people may be on edge if they're experiencing symptoms during the pandemic. But without the common COVID-19 symptoms of fever and fatigue, people should try to determine whether they're experiencing allergies. Everyone's concerned. Every symptom we're kind of analyzing, Shaw said. But the itchy symptoms, the eyes, nose and throat, will not be present in COVID-19. If you like the video, do not forget to like it, subscribe to the channel and activate the alarm bell so that all new messages come to you. Thanks for watching. Stay safe and secure, and see you in the next video.